Country News. This is a breaking news alert.
And good afternoon. We continue to follow breaking news of what has become a huge story in Omaha, a deadly officer-involved shooting from last night.
We're waiting for Omaha Police to hold a news conference any minute now about the shooting at the Wendy's near 43rd and Dodge. Here's what we know right now. It started with a robbery call around 9:20 last night. Officers called for backup and shots were fired. The suspect was shot and killed, and a crew member from the TV show Cops, Bryce Dion, seen here in this group photo right there. He was also shot and later died at the hospital.
Langley Productions released this statement this afternoon, quote, "We are deeply saddened and shocked by this tragedy, and our main concern is helping his family any way we can. Bryce Dion was a long-term member of the Cops team and a very talented and dedicated person. We mourn his passing. An investigation is ongoing, and we are cooperating with local authorities." We have live team coverage this afternoon.
KMTV Action 3 News reporters Megan Matthews and Josh Egbert are live at police headquarters. Megan, let's start with you.
Craig, Jen, we're inside the auditorium, inside of OPD headquarters. We're waiting for Police Chief Todd Schmatterer to come out and update us on what happened last night at 43rd and Dodge. There are three poster boards already set up behind me. Those could possibly lay out what happened last night. So this press conference should start momentarily. We're all set up here. Reporter Josh Egbert is also with me to update us on the Cops TV production company.
Yeah, Langley Productions expected here at this press conference as well. I'm told John Langley, the president of the production company, as well as the executive producer, will also be here making a statement. And of course, we will bring you all what they have to say about Bryce Dion and his work with the Cops TV show. Spent many years producing this. They have been in Omaha since about early July filming a segment for this. And again, we're just waiting to hear this press conference, which is about to begin any second. Jen and Craig.
All right, thanks, guys. Police have been at the scene of the shooting all day collecting evidence.
Senior reporter Jake Wasikowski is live near 43rd and Dodge with a scene setter from there. Jake?
Yeah, guys, we are outside of this Wendy's. Let me get out of the shot and let my photographer, Thelson Mack, push in. As you can see, those bullet holes still riddled through the windows here at Wendy's. We've reported about 17 of them just through those three windows you see there, as investigators still inside the Wendy's piecing together exactly what happened. The police presence has decreased throughout the afternoon. What makes this whole scene puzzling is I've talked to a few witnesses who said that they saw the robbery suspect lying on the ground in the Wendy's parking lot, yet there were bullet holes in the Palm Beach tanning building about 50 yards to the east. There were at least three bullet holes 50 yards to the east over and across another parking lot in that Palm Beach tanning building on about 42nd and Dodge. So once again, guys, police are still out here, not letting anybody back inside of this Wendy's. Obviously, they are closed for the day as they continue to piece together what happened out here. But obviously, we'll know much more soon.
All right. Thank you, Jake. Let's get back down to Omaha Police Headquarters.
We understand Police Chief Todd Schmatterer is at the podium right now. Let's listen in.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Todd Schmatterer. I'm Chief of Police for the City of Omaha. With me today, the mayor of the City of Omaha, Mayor Gene Stothert, the executive producers of the Cops production show, Morgan and John Langley. Also with me are Deputy Chiefs Mary Newman and Deputy Chief Dave Baker. The purpose of this press conference is to provide an accounting of the robbery incident that occurred last night at the Wendy's restaurant at 43rd and Dodge Street. Before I get into the details of the incident last night, last night and today is an emotionally tough time for the Cops production crew family and the Omaha Police Department. While documenting the Omaha Police Department response to the robbery, 38-year-old Cops production crew member Mr. Bryce Dion was killed by gunfire in the incident. On behalf of the men and women of the Omaha Police Department, I want to offer my sincere condolences to the family, friends, and co-workers of Mr. Bryce Dion. Also shot and killed during the robbery incident was 32-year-old suspect Mr. Cortez Washington. Our condolences to the family and friends of Mr. Washington. The details of the incident, as I can report them at this time, are as followed. On Tuesday, August 26, 2014, at 9:05 p.m., Omaha police officers were dispatched to a robbery at the Little Caesars Pizza located at 637 North Saddle Creek Road. The suspect at that robbery was identified as a white female. An Omaha police detective, Detective Darren Cunningham, also responded to the robbery at Little Caesars. He's on his way there. At 9:20 p.m., Detective Cunningham called for backup to the Wendy's restaurant at 4308 Dodge Street for a robbery in progress. Detective Cunningham provided a description of the suspect as wearing a black hoodie and a white bandana. Detective Cunningham asked for his backup officers to expedite. Within 15 seconds, officers Brooks Riley and Jason Wilhelm arrived. Officers Riley and Wilhelm were working a two-officer car, accompanied by two employees, Michael Lee and Bryce Dion of Langley Productions, the producers of the popular Cops television program. Mr. Lee was operating the video camera, and Bryce was operating the sound equipment. Immediately upon arrival, all three officers entered the Wendy's restaurant. Officers Cunningham and Riley entered through the east door of the building, followed by the cameraman, Mr. Lee. Officer Wilhelm entered through the west door of the building. Officers immediately confronted the robbery suspect, 32-year-old Cortez Washington, who was armed with a handgun. Multiple gunshots were fired inside of the Wendy's restaurant. Three individuals inside of Wendy's witnessed Mr. Washington holding a handgun and discharged the handgun directly at Detective Cunningham and Officer Riley. The witnesses described hearing the suspect's handgun being fired and seeing the slide recoil with the shots. The first two audible shots were from Mr. Washington's handgun, according to the witnesses. The officers returned fire. Mr. Washington was injured by multiple gunshots, but was able to flee out of the east doors where he collapsed in the parking lot. Mr. Washington was placed into handcuffs. At that time, officers recovered a handgun from Mr. Washington. It has been determined that Mr. Washington's handgun is an airsoft pistol that fires plastic pellet bullets. The airsoft pistol looks and functions like an actual firearm. There are photos to my immediate left. Mr. Dion was also injured by a single gunshot and collapsed just inside the east doorway. Mr. Washington and Mr. Dion were both transported by Omaha Fire Rescue Squad to the University of Nebraska Medical Center, where they were pronounced dead shortly thereafter. Mr. Washington has a lengthy criminal history that includes a previous robbery arrest from the state of Missouri. On August 29, 2011, he started parole in Kansas City. He was transferred to Nebraska State Parole on September 25, 2013. His parole was due to expire on June 10, 2017. This incident is being investigated by the Omaha Police Department's Officer Involved Investigations Squad. Langley Productions and Wendy's are cooperating with the investigation. The Omaha Police Department's Officer Involved Investigation Squad has briefed Douglas County Attorney Don Klein. In addition, per state law, a grand jury will be convened to investigate the actions of the officers. The officers who discharged their weapons are 37-year-old Darren Cunningham. He is a 10-year veteran of the Omaha Police Department assigned to the Detective Bureau. 35-year-old Brooks Riley is a 4-year veteran of the Omaha Police Department assigned to the Northeast Precinct Uniform Patrol. His partner this night was 39-year-old Jason Wilhelm, also a 4-year veteran assigned to the Northeast Precinct. The investigation is in the early stages, but we felt it was imperative to brief the public with as much information as we have at this time. We are striving for unprecedented transparency in this investigation. There are additional interviews that need to be completed with officers that were involved in this incident, and of course the autopsy results have yet to be determined. Per Omaha Police Department policy, any officer who discharges his or her firearm in the course of duty, an injury or death occurs, is placed on a paid administrative leave pending homicide and internal affairs investigations. Omaha Police Officers Darren Cunningham, Brooks Riley, and Jason Wilhelm have been placed on paid administrative leave. Any additional information about this incident will come from our press information office or from myself directly. Langley Productions and the Cops Television production crew have been in Omaha since June of this year. Over the course of the past 2 months, the production crews have developed a close relationship with the officers that they ride with each and every day. Just as the officers face the dangers of policing with honor, courage, and integrity, so do the production crew of Cops. Langley Production and Cops Television played an important role in the investigation of this officer-involved shooting. Portions of the shootout were captured on the video shot by Mr. Lee. The video footage has been recovered and is evidence in the investigation. I want to add that Douglas County Attorney Don Klein, myself, and members of my executive command staff have viewed the footage, and based on our viewing of the footage, the officers had no choice other than to respond in which the manner they did. Mr. Dion paid the ultimate price for his service to provide the footage of the real-life dangers that law enforcement officers face on a daily basis to television viewers throughout the world. While I can't show the video, it's evidence and it's needed for the grand jury, we did provide still photos to show what the officers had encountered to the best of our ability, what we can give you right now, considering state law and the grand jury. I'm going to turn the podium over to Mayor Stothert for some comments, and then I will return to take some questions.
Thanks, Chief. First and foremost, let me express my sympathies to all the families involved in this incident and to the staff at COPS. Over the summer, the COPS crew and the officers they followed have become friends, and this is especially difficult for them. Last night, Chief Schmutter and his command staff arrived at the scene immediately to begin the investigation. That demonstrates their commitment to our city, the officers, their families, and everyone affected. I'm proud of the leadership in the Omaha Police Department and its focus on community relationships. Our entire community can be confident that the chief will lead a thorough and transparent investigation. And I'd like to turn the podium back to Chief for questions.
Thank you, Mayor. A few people in here I don't recognize. Welcome to our local media. Thank you for always being here with us through thick and thin. I'm going to ask that you say your name and the affiliation that you represent. When you ask a question, please speak loudly if you don't have a microphone so everybody can hear. I do want to start with our local affiliates to ensure that they get their questions answered. Channel 7, do you have a question?
I have one right here, KTV Channel 7. Was this a crossfire situation or were all the bullets traveling in the same direction?
When the officers entered from the east, the detective and Officer Brooks Riley, they entered, the cameraman followed. The cameraman and the audio person, they travel in tandem, okay? They travel in tandem. As they entered, it became a chaotic scene. The cameraman made his way into the eating area and was able to get down and hold the camera up. Bryce Dion, got stuck in the vestibule where they entered. When they encountered the suspect, and the gunfire ensued, and it's a very dramatic video. When the gunfire ensued, at some point, Mr. Washington started exiting his way out, as you can see in that bottom picture there. He's on his way out. The officers are returning fire. Bryce is in that vestibule and gets struck by a round. WTWT, do you have a question for me?
Having cops here, does this change your decision in any way in allowing them?
That's a good question. You know, I haven't slept since this happened. I asked cops invited, sent an invitation to come. And I took them up on their invitation because I knew that they were an excellent organization, very professional entity. And the Omaha Police Department is a super agency, but we had some rough times, Brian. And we had an issue that occurred about a year and a half ago that we've overcome, and we've become a very professional, strong organization. And I wanted cops to come in so that they can see the Omaha Police Department and put a period on the past and show everybody how professional and how adept we are at doing the work. And I've seen 6 or 7 of the shows that can be aired, and it just shows amazing professionalism. I will tell you this. It was a very professional response by the officers who entered that and put themselves in peril during this situation. You asked me if I regret it. I don't regret it in one sense because I wanted to be transparent for the community. I thought transparency was the way to instill and better police community relations. Personally, I will live with this forever. If I'd have known this would happen, of course I wouldn't have done it. Next question, Mr. Becker, do you have a question?
Yes, sir. Was there excessive force? The report is that over 30 shots had been fired. Is that excessive force? I had someone comment to me that were wondering if the police were actually like showing off of the cameras. That was sort of an incident. Would this have been a normal response?
Absolutely ridiculous. They were not showing off of the cameras. Like I said, I personally viewed this. My command staff personally viewed it. Douglas County Attorney viewed this. This was a very harrowing situation. There was 3 officers involved. Take a look at the still photos, and I'm going to tell you that first 2 shots that they sounded like a gun. And if you can tell me which one's real and which one's not real from this gun, I don't know if you
so
can.
The shots were from the pellet gun. The shots were from the airsoft gun, and it sounded real.
Yes, they did. They very much did. So any criticism on that front is simply unmerited. The grand jury will see this video, and I'm very confident they will come to the very same conclusion that I come to. KMTV, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to skip you.
Chief, KMTV, will cops stop production?
We haven't gotten that far. My concern right now is for the cops production crew, their coworkers, their family. My concern is for this investigation to be done as thoroughly and as transparent as possible. My concern is with my officers who are taking this extremely hard. I am telling you, Bryce was their friend. This is if we lost one of our own. That is the grieving process we're going through right now. He was an incredible man, and the tears and the hugs that I got when I got up to the hospital, I could feel the pain of the officers in this matter. Yes, sir.
Thomas Stanton, KFAB chief. Detective Cunningham, was en route to the first robbery. Did he see this going on inside the Wendy's, or how did he know?
That's a great question. Realize this, we are here trying to be as transparent as possible. This investigation is not complete. We haven't had a chance to interview the officers in its entirety, but we have enough evidence with the video and the witness and then the forensic pieces that I could come out here and give you a snapshot of what took place. It would be presumptuous, but a reasonable presumption to assume that he was on his way to investigate that robbery. It would take him along this path. I don't know if he saw it or got flagged down, because there were people in the parking lot that flagged the 2 officers down in the 2-officer car that arrived and said, he's in there, get in there. Something to that effect. And that's why the officers ran in. They thought they needed to rescue somebody. There was something bad going on inside. We will know the answer to that. I just don't at this time. Yes.
Hi, Chief. Frankie Thompson, Fox 42.
Hi, Frankie.
Our sources tell us that it could have been a police officer's bullet that hit Mr. Dion. Can you comment on that?
Yeah. It was, Frankie. This was a friendly fire situation. It was an officer's round that struck Mr. Dion. Okay? Like I said earlier, Mr. Washington's gun was an airsoft gun. And while it looked and sounded and the slide slid like it was real, it was a pellet gun. Okay? Yes, Melissa.
Had Dion and Lee been with these 2 officers the last 2 months?
Had they been with the same two officers, or do they do any sort of rotation? And what kind of training is in place when these, I guess it's kind of a dual question for both the production and yourself, but from the Omaha Police standpoint, what kind of training do you require between the officers and the camera crew?
They don't necessarily ride with the same officers every night. A lot of times they're with the same crew. And the whole point is to get a snapshot of various officers and various viewpoints of what's going on in the city. The production crew is trained. The Omaha Police Department really just has them in the car, and they're trained to follow and report and do the things that they need to do. I want to make sure the Omaha World Herald gets a question. I can't believe I forgot you, Maggie. I'm so sorry.
It's okay, Chief. You mentioned the officers went in because they felt they need to rescue someone.
Yeah.
It was our understanding that maybe an employee had a gun being held to her head at that moment. And is that standard operating procedure for officers to enter a building during an ongoing robbery?
We are still looking into the information that an employee had a gun to their head, okay? Those points will really come out with deeper interviews. Our protocol is a preservation of life, first and foremost. There are times in which we can wait, and there are times in which we need to take action. When these officers arrived, again, there was people in the parking lot that came through the drive-thru motioning the officers that something was going on in there. The officers didn't have the luxury of doing anything other than what they were trained to do, and I will say courageously entered into that hostile environment with the premise of saving lives. That was their premise. Okay, they don't know if an employee of Wendy's was getting hurt, if a patron of Wendy's was getting hurt. They went in to find out.
Chief, as a follow-up, I apologize.
Absolutely.
You mentioned there were three witnesses inside the Wendy's.
There was.
Were those employees or any of them customers as well?
Two employees and then one off-duty employee who came in as a customer to say hello. He often did that. And their witness accounts are very consistent. Next question, please. Yes.
How many shots were fired? I've heard and I've seen reports that as many as 30 shots were fired.
There were multiple shots fired. There were three officers involved, okay? Multiple shots fired. The exact number, I'm not going to give at this point in time because it is subject of a grand jury investigation. Realize that my talking points and the evidence I'm able to provide here today has been vetted through the Douglas County Attorney's Office, because at some point this does have to be presented for trial. The inference behind the question is, was that an excessive number of shots that took place in this incident? And I don't believe that it was, based on what I've seen.
Were the members of the comp's production crew wearing any protective gear or vests?
They were, Dave. They wear ballistic vests. This round, and the autopsy's not back yet, but it came in the left arm and slipped in on between the vest where there's an open area. Yes.
Chief, were the officers in this chaotic situation inside the Wendy's aware that Bryce was trapped in that vestibule?
I don't see how they could have been. I don't know. We're going to talk to him, and I don't want to speak out of turn, but when Mr. Washington started exiting and pointing his weapon on his way out, it forced the officers to continue their gunfire. And I can tell you that nobody wanted Bryce to get hurt. Nobody wanted anybody to get hurt. Police work is very dangerous. It's very chaotic. And when you're reporting police work and riding along with us, unfortunately, you subject yourself to that same level of violence that Omaha police officers do every day. Good question. I don't know. Per state law, one will convene. The exact time frame of it, I'm just not an expert of how that will go.
You mentioned that.
Let me go to Joe real quick.
Yeah, we're Bryce and the other production.
Joe Chiodo with
WOW.
There you go, Joe.
Were they aware that they were going into an armed robbery situation?
Yes, they were.
Okay, so that is normal.
Yeah, they remember, the detective said expedite my backup. They knew they were going to potential armed robberies. They just didn't know if the suspect was there or not until they confronted the people in the front. And that's when they thought, we need to go in. Two of them went in together. One of them went around the other side. They took a very, very good tactical approach to this. Okay? This wasn't a haphazard approach. This, from what I saw, it was a very professional, tactical approach to entering that building. Yes?
Chief Frankie Thompson, Fox 42 News. We knew that your intentions were well when you invited the show to come here, but now this incident has hit national news and it's been buzzing all day. How do you feel our city is perceived now because of this?
Look, the city of Omaha is a tremendous city. The Omaha Police Department is a very professional organization. Last year, there were 42 homicides in this city, 33 or 4 at this time. This year, there's only been 17. Okay, you put that up against a lot of cities, it's a very nice city. And it's professional law enforcement and our police community relations and our partnerships in the community that got us to this point. This is an unfortunate incident, but I do not believe it should be anything viewed other than that. An unfortunate incident that occurred during police work that takes on very dangerous elements. And I will be out if need be to defend how great this city is.
Chief, so TMZ has released audio of the police call. Did the police department release that, or did that come from Langley Productions?
You know, I don't know where they got it.
I believe it came from a website.
Okay.
There's a website online that I think people from police scanners.
This is Morgan Langley with Langley Productions. I don't know. Like I said, we're early in this yet, Tom. Yeah.
Chief, I was wondering if we could ask Langley Productions a couple questions.
Yeah, absolutely can. Let me turn the podium over to him.
Hey, gentlemen. First of all, can you just kind of talk about how long Bryce has been with the company and just kind of what kind of...
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to talk about that. I mean, Bryce has been with us for 7 years, and honestly, he really is one of our best. This is a hard time for us. He's a very talented guy, and he did something that he loved and was passionate about. And we've been very fortunate over the years so that we've never had an incident like this. Unfortunately, this happened, and you know we're dealing with it, and it's a very sad day for us.
Can you tell us any more about Bryce? You know, where he was from, if he had family?
Yeah, Bryce is a very private guy. He's from the Boston area originally. He's a single guy. He was just promoted this year to sound supervisor. Just a great guy, very positive. And our primary concern is for his family, and it's a tough one for us. It's a big blow for us.
Morgan, do you know how long cops have left the dome here?
Yes, we have 1 week left here, and obviously this is going to affect that time because we have. Our other crew members are in counseling, and
we don't know what we're, obviously we haven't gotten around, as the chief said, to really figuring out what we're going to do here in Omaha. The main thing for us is we want to make sure that Bryce is respected and that people know he was a great guy and a hard worker, and
overall,
and he was passionate.
Could you compare what you saw over the period of time you were here, Omaha Police Department, how they responded to calls versus other reports that you see around the country?
You know, we get asked those kinds of questions a lot, and we see footage, obviously, from all over the country, from all kinds of departments. And I think, to answer that specifically, I think they're a very professional department.
I would like to make another point that someone asked the chief about how this affects Omaha. We film in Las Vegas. We film all over the country. And crime and this kind of thing is a very democratic issue. Crime is democratic. It happens in every major city in America, in every small town city. It's just a matter of degree. It's not a negative reflection on Omaha in any way, shape, or form. It's a tragic event for us and for Bryce's family.
Chief,
And for the Omaha Police Department, I might add, because the guys he was riding with were truly befriended by him and he befriended them. And that's very common in our job when you ride along with police officers on a daily basis.
Have you been able to talk to those officers and...
We literally just stepped off the plane and landed in the rain and came here, so.
Prior to this incident, what was the worst that any of your crew have encountered?
We've been very fortunate over the years, and somebody asked about training. I mean, we do train our guys. They're all provided with bulletproof vests. We train every year, most years, at a big seminar. Bryce is a veteran. He's been with us for 7 years. Our guys know a lot about this area. A lot of them are like you guys that come out of news organizations.
The difference is for us and for the viewers, COPS truly is a reality show. It's not manipulated, it's not managed, it's not staged. It's all true and it's real and it happens as it happens. And unfortunately, that's our highlight and our low light in this particular instance.
Have you thought about how on air you'll honor him?
We've thought a little bit about it. I think it's a little premature to talk about. We are thinking about that. As I said, honestly, he's one of our best guys, just promoted this year, very talented, very dedicated to his job, and it's hard for me. I hired him, so it's hard for me to talk about.
And you're Morgan and your son.
Father and son.
I'll take one more question if you have any for the police, but Langley Productions literally just got off the plane, so we're going to cut it short with them. I'll take another question. Kevin Cole, you got a question?
What type of weapons were the officers using?
I would have to verify. We will verify that at some point. It was their service weapons. I always get tricked into one more question. I'm not looking over here this time.
Yep. They went into the restaurant, did they know there was one individual or did they think that there may have been more?
The information that they had, remember, that came from the detective, was a single suspect wearing a black hoodie and a white bandana. Okay, everybody, I appreciate you doing your job. Thank you very much, and have a good evening.
Omaha Police Chief Todd Schmatter wrapping up a news conference at Omaha Police Headquarters in what has been a very stunning and tragic turn of events here in